Dr. Maung Zarni's Canadian tour dropped by Toronto City Hall last week. The goal was to bring public awareness to the alleged genocide of Muslims in Burma, or Myanmar, as the nation is called today. Dr. Zarni contends that what's happening to Burma's Muslim minority at the hands of the Buddhist majority qualifies as ethnic cleansing. And indeed, this is the narrative that is being reported by most Western media outlets. But there are others who believe the vilification of the country's Buddhist majority government is an elaborate PR stunt, one that depicts Muslims as oppressed victims and Buddhists as oppressors, when a case can be made that it is Muslim militants who are responsible for the bloodshed and carnage in Burma. And things certainly got heated at City Hall when an activist for Burma's Buddhists, Rick Heizman, interrupted Dr. Zarni's presentation in an attempt to offer such a contrarian viewpoint.
You should be removed. You should be removed from this meeting. You're complicit and you're complacent.
You're disturbing a very... You should be removed from here.
You're
probably a Holocaust denier also. You're denying this genocide because you're also a Holocaust denier, and you have to leave. You should get out. No, you should leave, and you should leave too.
No, I am going.
Get out.
No, you're deniers.
You should be removed. You should be removed from here.
Tempers continued to flare, and Heizman was eventually escorted out of City Hall by security guards. It was outside that we caught up with Heizman to get his side of the story regarding the alleged ethnic cleansing of Muslims in Burma. My first question, I simply wanted to find out what was behind his outburst.
You know, we had a pro-Rohingya group there, and you know, not that many there considering the size of the panel, actually. But, you know, they're telling absolute bullshit and lies and misinterpretation, and they want the total destruction, really, of Burmese people and Buddhism in general.
As for his motivation, Heizman says he's an admirer of Buddhist culture, and he has been to Burma 28 times, typically spending more than a month each time. And he's also been able to access Burma's so-called Ground Zero.
Ground Zero means Maung Da and Butitong provinces in which total atrocities happened, such as the type that those people in that room don't want to hear. They don't even want to know, and they won't believe it because they're Muslim or Muslim sympathizers. But on the night of the jihad, with so many coordinated simultaneous attacks, there were villages such as a Hindu village, a Hindu minority village, in which 92 people of 102 people were killed. And 8 of them were spared only because they were good-looking young women. And they were forced to convert. First of all, they were forced to watch them knife their husbands and sometimes even babies to death. And then they were forced to convert to Islam or die, and they were then married to older men they had not even seen yet, and they were taken into Bangladesh, and they thought their life was over, and somebody discovered that they were not the Bengali Muslims there, Bengali Hindus, and they were rescued out of there. Okay, now in that village, 92 people died, one person survived. I interviewed her too. And believe me, those kinds of interviews are pretty hard to do.
I also asked him about the contention, which is rarely reported, that the Muslim minority has brought this crisis upon themselves, given that some allege that the Muslim minority started this conflict going back some 75 years ago.
In 1942, there's a well-documented massacre called the Maung Da Massacre, where they rose up with World War II weapons, killed 30,000 Buddhists in Maung Da Town alone, sent 100,000 or more into fleeing for their lives by burning 400 plus Buddhist villages. They simply think they have the divine right to kill anybody that is not Muslim. To them, other people are like cutting grass or something. You can just simply do it. We have videotapes from this recent episode from captured terrorists or dead terrorists from their cell phones. We have videotapes of them training, them putting their black hoods on, grabbing their weapons, lining up, ready to march to a Buddhist village to kill everybody. We have videos of kids, probably 5 years old, with big old machetes, smiling and saying, "We want to kill Buddhists. We want to chop the heads off Buddhists. We want to do that."
So if what Heizman is alleging is true, is this another case in which Muslims are winning the PR war?
Okay, first of all, in Asia, the press is much different than here. And I was just in Asia for 6 weeks. The Indian press is extremely good. And it's in English most of the time, so you can get it without translation for that matter. Indian press, very good. And they are very concerned. In fact, they're talking about expelling all of the Rohingya illegal refugees who are in India anyway. They just simply don't like them. They want to get rid of them. They have their own Muslim problems. China press is supportive. Thailand and Sri Lanka very supportive because they have their own issues with Muslims doing the same sort of things. The Muslim world, in the Muslim world, the media is even more askew than it is in the Western world. The Muslim world, it's like stories circulate around, you know, that millions of, you know, they say millions even beyond the population number, millions of Muslims are being murdered all the time and blah, blah, blah. And they're riling up the whole Muslim world for a jihad.
Now, as we showed you, Heizman wanted to make these points inside City Hall, but he was prevented from doing so. So I asked him what his response was to the response he received, in which he was labeled everything from a Holocaust denier to an Islamophobe.
Oh, I'm very Islamophobic. I mean, I am fearful of Islam because of what it can do in the world. Aren't you too? I mean, I'm proud to be Islamophobic.
As well, Heizman maintains that the true end goal of the Muslim minority in Burma is to transform the nation into a Muslim majority country. And he points to neighboring Bangladesh as a grim cautionary tale.
There's two agendas here. We have the short-term agenda is to take Rakhine State. Well, just like Muslims took Bangladesh at one time. I mean, Bangladesh itself was a Hindu and Buddhist kingdoms for 2,000 years and then became Muslim. And there's still 1% of the population is Buddhist, but they are eliminating that as fast as they can. So they basically want to take Rakhine State. Well, what is next is Burma. And this has been a continuation ever since Islam started to push out and annihilate every Buddhist culture they encounter, and they have.
Finally, I wanted to get Heisman's take on the Toronto City Councillor who served as the MC for this presentation, namely Kristen Wong Tam. After all, Miss Wong Tam is openly lesbian, and we know how well people of different sexual orientations are typically received in Islamic society.
Well, I come from San Francisco, so I understand the gay, the lesbian, blah, 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 groups and so on. And I'm astounded at how stupid they are about Islamic terrorism and so on. Like, if you brought up, you know, something, we're having a protest against Islamic terrorism here. Can you gay groups join us? In other words, they're all pro-Islamic because... You know, what's in their head? I don't know. They don't, even if you tell them, hey, you know, if you were to walk any street in Iran or so, you're going to be executed if they know that you're gay. I mean, kill, push off a building is the typical thing. It's astounding how Islam trumps everything.
Bottom line, obviously, the debate will continue to rage regarding what's going on in Burma today. But is there any tolerance when it comes to allowing both sides of the story to make their respective cases? Rick Heizman simply wanted to make his viewpoints known to those taking in the Toronto City Hall presentation. But apparently, when it comes to any sort of narrative that depicts Muslims as victims, a contrarian opinion is opinion non grata, even in a Western democracy such as Toronto. I wonder why. For the Rebel.media, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies.